Hey YouTube, I want to talk about how you guys are being used as a sentiment indicator for the price of silver. And, you know, literally a human VIX for silver. Before we get started though, I've gotten a ton of emails and, you know, some of you are going to be kind of left out in the dark here a little bit because you may not have logged onto my channel this weekend. I want to give you the backstory and let you know exactly what happened here. So on Saturday, I was reading Kiko forums, and there was a thread about a bullion dealer. You know, it was a small bullion dealer, and you know, these kind of threads pop up all the time because there's a lot of small bullion dealers, and people want to know, before I place an order, do you guys have any experience with these guys? Happens all the time. And Kiko has since deleted that thread because, well, it's a Kiko forum, and they kind of frown upon people asking about other dealers. So that's neither here nor there. But when, you know, I was reading through the comments and one of them really stood out. Somebody said, wow, 1 ounce lunars for $22.60. Now, you know, that caught my attention really quickly. So I decided to check them out. I went onto their website to look at what they had, and the prices were, quite frankly, pretty amazing. Okay. You know, as a lot of people commented, and I do agree with the sentiment, they look too good to be true. Okay, I'd never seen, a 5 ounce lunar goat for under $100. It was like $96. 1 ounce lunars for $22.60. So right there, here's my quandary. Do I make a video about it? Okay, I try to put in every disclaimer that I could think of. And yet, is that enough? Should I just not say a word? Now, I know a lot of people are going to say, yeah. Yeah, you shouldn't even say a word. And, you know, honestly, it's probably the smartest advice that you could give me. I get that. Okay? Should I just send a few people an email? You know, then it becomes like an exclusionary thing. You know, why is this guy just kind of, you know, letting a couple of people know and not the rest of us? I've never really believed in that. I kind of feel like this is the whole point of a community. And I know that some people hate that term. I'm not part of a community. I get that. It's just simply what I call it. A group of people that get together to share, you know, ideas, exchange ideas. That was kind of the whole point of the channel. And I've always felt like we all benefit greatly because of our association with each other, whether it's finding out the good deals, whether it's finding out what people think will be, a hot coin or whatever. We all benefit from that. So I think if I started sending out emails to like 10 people, it would, I don't know, it's like the cool kid lunch table, you know, and you're not invited. That doesn't seem right to me. Okay. It just, you know, should I discuss it in a private chat? I've seen that happen before. And again, it's exclusionary. So that's the quandary I'm left with. Do I discuss this? Common sense says that, you know, I put it out there and people can discuss it and they can do what they want to do from that point. One thing that I left out of the video that I should have included was, if you're unsure, use a credit card. Pay the extra 3%. And somebody brought that up, which is perfect, which is exactly why you make those videos, is because, you know, somebody brings it in the comment section and includes something that you forgot to mention. And that was a great idea. You know, if you were unsure, use a credit card. So I woke up the next morning and scrolled through the comments, and somebody left a comment saying that I had zero integrity because I made the video. Okay, so right now, or right then, I'm thinking, okay, is something wrong here? You know, is this just simply a personal attack because this person doesn't like me? Is this, did I do something wrong in this video? I mean, what did I do wrong here? So to err on the side of caution, I made the video private. And I sent this person an email. I said, you know, what was that comment all about? You know, would you like to explain it? Or, you know, did I do something wrong here? And I didn't get an explanation. I just got another rude comment. So at that point, it's like, all right. So I'm not sure that I did anything wrong there. You know, I don't think sharing a deal with you guys is really anything out of the ordinary. The comment was puzzling to me, to say the least. But, you know, you can't go around trying to please everybody. If you try to please everybody, you end up pleasing nobody. So at a certain point, you just do your thing and don't worry about the noise. So basically, so then I got quite a few emails from people asking why I took the video down. Suddenly it becomes a cause of concern. So my intention was to call the company on Monday morning, which I did. I left very pleased. Oh, and I should also include, I've also had a couple of subs email me and leave a comment on Mr. Vegeta's video saying that they, in fact, have bought from this company and the transaction went well. One person said, I bought a 10-ounce Kook last year. They had similar pricing last year. They had too good, quote-unquote, too good to be true pricing. I bought a 10-ounce Kook. Everything went great. So that was good to hear. So I called them for peace of mind. This is not a fly-by-night operation that just popped up yesterday. They've been around for a few years. They said that typically shipping is about a two-week thing. So I asked them, I said, you know, there's a good chance that, you know, you could see a lot of business here, a lot more than you're used to in a short term, or a short period of time, due to the exposure that you're getting on YouTube. Are you going to be able to handle that? And they assured me that they would be able to. I also told them, I said, look, and here's the other thing. This is a dual-edged sword, just so you know. You're going to get a lot of exposure here on YouTube. You know, people are going to be doing unboxings and talking about your company. So if you come through for them, you're going to really look good out of this. You know, if you don't, that's the dual-edged part of the sword. They're going to take you to, they're going to really skewer you in a public way. So you got to make sure that you, they assured me again that they've been at this for a while, you know, so I felt pretty good after having this conversation. Also, I asked them, I said, look, I said this, and this is a good thing. I said, this pricing seems like it's too good to be true. I said, are these factory seconds? Okay, factory seconds. I call it factory seconds. Are these grading rejects? And they assured me that they are not grading rejects. If they get a pile of silver that would qualify as a grading reject, they said that they would mark them as such and mark them down a little bit. You know, you'll see those sometimes like on Atmex, right? Abrasions and everything else. Bottom line is, I left that phone call feeling pretty good, and you know, I was okay with it. If you're feeling hesitant, wait till everybody starts you know, getting their silver and unboxing and relaying the experience. You know, or like I said, use a credit card if you're feeling unsure. Okay, and we're 7 minutes into telling the quick story. So as far as the sentiment indicator, so Silver Futurist did a video last week or so. And whenever I watch a video like this, it really strikes me as odd because I feel like I interact with enough people in the silver community that I feel like I have a pretty good gauge. I feel like I have my finger on the pulse of the silver community, if you will. And he came out and he said that, you know, basically that there was human sacrifice, cats and dogs living together, you know, mass hysteria, to steal Bill Murray's line from Ghostbusters. And I'm paraphrasing. That's not what Silver Futurist said exactly. But he basically said that sentiment was definitely at a real low, and that anxiety was at a high point. And it was funny because I sat there and I listened to this video, and then I thought back to the video that I made where I basically said that, you know, it looks like the bottom's going to be broken out of silver here in this channel. We're going to be going down to about 1750, 1775 at least. You know, I got 10 thumbs down. I mean, that's pretty standard for a video. Nobody is freaking out on the video. Everybody's pretty rational. In some ways, I don't know what he's seeing. Maybe you guys are just simply too moderate. I don't know. I really don't know. I think you are taken in stride. But look, it's capitulation 101. They're looking for you guys to freak out. So maybe we should just all start freaking out so that maybe we can get this thing over with. But they're literally looking for, you know, something big to happen. And it's amazing to me that they think it's going to happen on YouTube, right? A channel doesn't have to shut down. There doesn't have to be, you know, a fund that blows up or anything like that to signal a bottom. But that's exactly what they're looking for. They're looking for that moment, that Lehman moment for silver. What's that going to be? I really don't know if there is even going to be one. You know, there's been plenty of bottoms that have formed, you know, without having that, you know, capitulation style event. But that's exactly what they're looking for here. You know, and I'll tell you what, I've been that guy that capitulated before. You know, one quick story. I own CMGI, and I think this was like around 98, 99 or whatever. And boy, I tell you what, this thing was going through a petrifying plunge. And this is before the internet. I mean, the internet existed, but, you know, what didn't have the mass penetration that it has today. But and there was no cell phones. So I was driving with my wife, and I had to go to, I was like freaking out. I was in the car. We were doing something. And every time I saw a payphone, I'd get out and I'd call my broker. I had like a, probably like a Fidelity account, and they had a touch tone system. So I'd go on there and do the touch tone thing to get the CMGI quote, and it was lower every single time I did it. And I started freaking out, and I couldn't take it anymore because this thing had been going down every day, and it was just an absolute gut check for me. And I was like, you know what? I got to get out of this thing. So basically, I found one more phone, and I placed a limit order. And I basically went back, and it was it just kept going down. I couldn't actually exercise my cell. So at a certain point, I said, you know what? Forget about it. And I just sold at market. And it was probably the most illiquid time that I could do it. And it was, I sold it. And I found out what my print was. And it was like literally, I don't even know if, it must have been the absolute lowest point of the day because it immediately popped back up. And I just sat there and shook my head and I said, are you kidding me? But you know, I was finally rid of this cancerous stock. And of course, it just kept going up from there. And it went all the way up until the tech bubble exploded in 2001. That's capitulation. That's the gut check time. They're looking for you guys to pick up your safe, load it into your car, drive down to your coin shop, dump it on his desk and say, get rid of it. I don't care. Whatever you're going to give me. Give me 16 bucks an ounce. I don't care. I need out. I hate this metal. I never want to see it again. I'm going to go join a silver basher website. And for the rest of my life, I'm going to do nothing but bash silver. You know, that's what they're looking for from you guys. Are they going to see it? I don't know. Here's what you got to understand. There's nothing that you personally can do, buying or selling, that's going to impact silver one penny. The silver market's not sitting there waiting for you to do anything. Okay, you can sit there and hold your silver and it could go down a little further. You could sell your silver, it could go down even further. It could bounce back just as aggressively. I don't know. All I know is that what I'm seeing from you guys is pretty rational discussion. You know, whether it's on the chats or whether it's on, the thread of one of my videos. You know, I hear discussions about new coin designs. You know, what does the outlook look like? I'm hearing pretty rational discussion. So from my point of view, that's a good thing. But that's not what they're looking for, guys. You know, imagine that you were completely uninvolved. How would it feel? What would you be looking at? You'd probably be looking at lower silver prices, in all honesty. If you took all the emotion out of it, and you took an outsider's perspective. How much lower? I'm not sure. It doesn't feel quite like a bottom just yet, but who knows? So, all right. Well, give me your thoughts, guys. I know there's a lot here to chew on, but all right. I'll talk to you later.